this tutorial time, but first, let me take a selfie. Hi, it's your friendly neighborhood VTuber Suvi here again with a new general VTubing related tutorial. So today we're gonna go through different applications you can use to take screenshots of your VTubing avatar. Now while this may sound like an easy topic, it is actually a bit difficult to find the perfect application that suits every use. So today we're gonna go through three applications, and you can then figure out which one suits your uses the best. And if there is some application you feel that should be on this list, feel free to drop it in the comments down below. I would definitely love to know about that one. Anyway, the links to the programs are in the description, so shall we get started then? Okay, so the first application on our list is the good old Vroid Studio. So, you probably know this as a VTuber, but you can use Vroid Studio to take screenshots of your character by going to the camera / exporter tab. In here, you can pose your character either by using the existing animations and stopping the animation mid-frame, or you can go to the pose and then select some of the default poses to use as a base, and then you can move the bones around simply by dragging them. You can also adjust the hand shape from the list here for both of the hands, like so. And also how much the hand pose is weighted on the hand. Now, in addition to this, you can change the facial expression of your character. Now, if you're going for screenshots, I highly recommend you turn off the auto blink, because this will usually make your character blink when you're taking the screenshot. So turn that one off. Now you can then adjust the key shapes to make some kind of facial expression for your character. The next step is to adjust the background. Now, if you are making this character to have a transparent background, then you will sadly need to use a color key, because Vroid Studio doesn't support capturing of images with transparent background. So usually it's a good idea to use some color that is not used in your avatar at all. So that could be a green screen, or it could be a blue screen or anything else. You will need to remove this in your paint program. Next, you can go to the post-processing effects, and in here you probably want to set the anti-alias on. This will blur the edges of the character really nicely, but this may of course have a slight effect when you are removing the green screen. Alternatively, if you are just creating an art piece, you could go to the background and load a background image already in Vroid and use that as the background instead of removing it. You should also set the capture size to be something higher, especially if you are removing the background, let's say to 4K. Now, when you remove the background and scale down the avatar, this will decrease the green edges around your avatar. Once you're totally happy with the pose, you can just click the capture button to save the image. Now, the downfalls with Vroid Studio is that you can only capture those models that are in Vroid format. So if you have already exported your model to VRM file and edited that in Unity, you can no longer bring it back to Vroid Studio. Also, if you have made your model completely in Blender or some other program, you also will not be able to bring it back. So this is only suitable for those who are creating their avatars in Vroid Studio and not really touching them anywhere else. So it is not optimal for most cases. The next program on our list is VWorld. Now, this is more like a game rather than a screenshot program. This will basically load up a 3D world where you can move around your avatar, just like a game character. So to load your avatar, simply go to the top left corner, click that one, and you can import your model either from hard drive or from VROID Hub. And so once it has loaded in, you will see your character on the screen. And now you can start moving around your camera to pose it around, and you can click spacebar to take a screenshot. And then you need to click the green icon to take the actual screenshot. Now, in addition to this, you can click Tab to bring up some settings where you can adjust, for example, the pose your character is playing. You can also stop the animation, which makes it easier for you to take the screenshot. In addition to this, you can adjust the effects like the depth blur, bloom, and all the other effects that are listed here. In addition to this, you can move around your character. Now if you click Tab again, that will link your camera to the character. And now you can use the keys listed at the bottom left corner to move your character around. And you can move the character all around the world and find a nice spot to take the screenshot. And you can click Tab again to get to the actual camera view where you can pose your character and then take the screenshot. In addition to this, you can actually completely construct the world by adding items. Wherever you want, you can even go as far as adding complete buildings to the map. You can then adjust the size of these objects as well. In addition to this, you can also change the day cycle. As you can see, there is day currently, but you can adjust the time, and this will easily bring it to night. So all in all, this application is really useful if you want to pose your character in a 3D world. But it is of course not suitable for taking those collaboration pictures where you need a transparent background. Okay, and finally we have VRM Doll Play. Now, this one is probably my favorite, and it is the program that I personally use to take any screenshots of my characters. Now, this one has two versions available. There is the desktop version, and there is even a VR version. Personally, I was unable to get the VR version working with Valve Index. It wasn't registering any button presses. Maybe you will have more luck with that. Anyway, even the desktop version is amazing. So, to use this, we simply drag and drop VRM files to the scene. And then we load it in and let the program process for a bit. And now the program has several different modes for you to control your avatar. The default mode you see here right now allows you to rotate your bones around. Now this may not be the most optimal way of getting a pose for you, so you can click the mode button, which starts the so-called ragdoll mode. And in the ragdoll mode, you can move the actual points around and your character will try to move the other bones accordingly. In addition to just moving around the bones, you can also control the hand shapes, a bit similar to how VROID Studio worked. So we have sliders that we can use for that. There's few different hand shapes that appear when you move around the sliders. You also have access to all the blend shapes available for your model. And in addition to this, you can click the full and you will have access to all the shape keys you have saved for your model. Okay, so let's say you want to take a photo with a transparent background. To do that, you just simply click the PNG, and you can remove the ground by clicking the ground and then clicking delete button. Now, if you were now to click the photo button, you could take a 2K, 4K or 8K picture with a transparent background. Now, if you need finer control over your character, you can click the mode again. And this will allow you to control all the bones of your avatar. Now, if you have lots of hair bones, then this might be a bit complicated, but it will allow you to do some really nice poses. And once you're happy with the pose, you can also save it as a TXT file or a PNG file. In addition to this, of course, you can use the already existing poses that come with the doll play. So if you go to the programs folder, you will see the pose folder. And in here, you will see lots of PNG files. Now you can simply drag and drop these on top of your model, and it will load the pose. So you can easily save your work and then resume it later. Another thing you can do is you can drag and drop in an image file, and that will become a plane like this. Now if you click this plane, you can move it around, you can rotate it around, and you can even scale it bigger. So you can create a background image for your art piece really easily this way. And now if you click the shadow, then your character will be casting a shadow on that specific image as well. And you can move around the light, and you can rotate the light, which moves the shadow. And just so it wouldn't be just this simple, you can also do something that none of the other programs can do, which is load in multiple VRM files. So you can simply drag and drop another of your VRM files like so, and it will process for a bit again. And then you can move around your other VRM file as well, and pose it as well, the way you want. So in addition to just posing the characters, we can also adjust all the effects and rotate the camera. We can adjust the camera field of view to zoom in closer. We can also rotate the camera around the Z-axis, which is usually lacking from all the other programs. We can then adjust all these post-processing effects as well. And if the markers are either too small or too big, you can adjust them as well. Or you can hide them if they are covering the view too much. And when you're done with everything, you can just simply click the photo button to take a photo of the current view, like so. So yeah, this definitely makes this program one of the best, if probably not the best, of the available programs that you can use to take screenshots of your VTuber models. I hope this tutorial was useful for you. And as I mentioned at the beginning of the tutorial, if you feel like some application was missing from the list, feel free to let me know in the comments down below. I would definitely love to hear about it. Anyway, if you enjoyed the content, consider subscribing down below, as well as smashing the bell button to stay tuned with my latest tutorials. Also, do consider following me on all those other social medias as well. We do also have a comfy little Discord. If you would like to join that, you can ask any questions you may run into there. I also do stream on Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Saturdays on Twitch, and you can ask any questions live as well if you want that. Anyway guys, see you next time! Bye bye!